Hey everyone, it's Josh here with HostGator. Today I'm going to show you how to resolve an issue when you recently changed your PHP version with MultiPHP Manager. So in this instance, I just recently changed my PHP version to 7.3. It's exactly what my site needs, but I'm having a really interesting and strange issue on my site. And today I'm going to show you how to fix that. So the first thing I want to show you how to do is we've got our PHP info page that's already created. I can see that I'm on 7.3. That's perfect. The only bad part is when I actually go to my site, it's got an error here. And so it's got some content warnings, and it also says that my PHP installation is missing the MySQL extension. And today I'm going to show you how to resolve this issue really quickly. The first thing I want to do is go to my file manager for the document root for this site. Now I'm working on b-redpit. That's my primary domain. That's always going to be in my public underscore HTML. So we'll jump here into file manager, and I'm just going to scroll down to find that folder. Here it is. We'll double click to get inside of it. Now the file I'm looking for today is my .htaccess file. This is a really important file to Apache, which is the web server, because it gives us a lot of different directives on what PHP version we should use and a whole bunch of different rules and rewrites, pretty much everything that the web server uses. So I want to go look inside of this file to see if there's anything that I can make a change to. So I'll right click and I'll do view just to get a look at it first. Now down here, you will see at the very bottom, you'll see the new PHP handler that was put in by MultiPHP Manager. You can note it because it says begin cPanel generated handler here, do not edit. Now right above it is actually my old PHP handler, and that was from PHP Selector, which is an older version of a program inside of cPanel that allows us to change or manipulate our PHP version. Now these two are actually conflicting, so what I need to do is go through and either remove or edit out the older one so that the new one can fully take effect. Now that I've got an idea of what I need to do, I'll show you how to do it. So I'll click the right X out of here to exit the view. And I'll want to take a full backup of this file before I make any changes. It's super important so I can always roll back. Even though the site's broken, it'll be good to know where I started. So I'm going to do a copy. And then all I need to do is give it the full path to the file. So I'll do .htaccess and I'll just do .bak for backup. Copy over that file. Got that file right here, so if in case I need to roll back, I've always got that option. Now I'm going to go and right click and edit the initial htaccess file. So as we noted earlier, we've got our old handler here and our new handler all the way at the bottom. What I'm going to do is essentially default or disable this add handler right here. So I can do one of two things. I can either completely remove this block of text right here, or I can comment it out. I'm a huge fan of non-destructive editing, and I like to use comments because it just makes it easier if I need to roll back. So what I'm gonna do is go through and add a hashtag to each one of these lines, little octothorp there. And what it's gonna do is essentially render that null and void inside the htaccess file. So it's not gonna be read by Apache, and I'm essentially disabling it completely. Now that I know it's all commented out, and you can see the colors change from their normal black or purple to green. So I've got a hashtag in front of each one of these. I will save changes. I got my success bar down there at the bottom. Tells me it's good. Now let's head back to my site, and I'm going to do a quick hard refresh. My site's back! I've officially fixed it. So I'm really glad to show you this option because it is something that you may come across when switching from the older PHP selector to our newer MultiPHP manager, which I think the MultiPHP is a little easier. But I'm really glad to show you this, and I hope it's helpful. Thanks again for watching. If you have any comments or suggestions, leave them below. And subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, y'all.